Hello everyone. Welcome to the weekly news bulletin of Netaji Subhash University. Let's start with today's headlines. PM Modi lays foundation stone for redevelopment of 508 railway stations, says opposition playing negative politics. Gyanvapi survey resumes on day 3. Mosque committee threatens boycott over rumors. Chandrayaan 3 successfully enters lunar orbit, informed by ISRO. At least 28 killed after train derails in southern Pakistan. Salman Khan bashes Abhishek Malhan for being arrogant about his followers. Fans have mixed reactions. Now the news in details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that the world's attitude towards India has changed completely and the country's prestige has increased on a global scale. The redevelopment process is a part of Amrit Bharat Station Scheme, which was launched to redevelop 1,309 stations across the country. Citing two major reasons behind the change in world's attitude towards India, the Prime Minister said, first, Indians brought in a full majority government after almost 30 years, and second, the full majority government took major decisions and continuously worked for a permanent solution to all challenges. Accused the opposition of playing negative politics, the Prime Minister said, now the entire country is rooting for corruption, dynasty and appeasement to quit India. Gyanvapi survey resumes on third day to determine if the 17th century mosque was constructed over a pre-existing structure. The Archaeological Survey of India resumed the survey of the Gyanvapi Mosque in Varanasi on the third day to determine if the 17th century mosque was constructed over a pre-existing structure, even as the Muslim side warned they would boycott the entire exercise if rumors are spread that Hindu religion symbols and objects have been found. Sudhir Tripathi, one of the advocates representing the Hindu side, said that differential global positioning system and other techniques and machines were used for the survey work. The Hindu side is satisfied with the survey work so far, he said. Sayyid Muhammad Yasin, the joint secretary of the Anjuman Intizamiya Committee, which manages the mosque, alleged that a section of media spread rumors that during survey of the Tehkhana, idols, Trishul and Kalash were found. If such acts are not contained, the Muslim side will once again boycott the survey work. Chandrayaan 3 successfully enters the lunar orbit. Indian Space Research Organization informed through its Twitter. The required maneuver was done from an ISRO facility stationed in Bengaluru, the city-headquartered space agency said. Chandrayaan 3 has been successfully inserted into the lunar orbit. A retro burning at the perilum was commanded from the Mission Operations Complex, ISRO Telemetry Tracking and Command Network, Bengaluru, the agency said in a tweet. At least 28 people were killed when an express train derailed in southern Pakistan. The railway minister said with an emergency declared at local hospital struggling to deal with dozens of injured. This is quite a big accident, Railway Minister Khwaja Saad Rafiq told reporters. According to the information so far, 28 passengers have been killed and many are injured. There can be two reasons. First, that it was a mechanical fault, or the fault was it might be a sabotage. We will investigate it. Salman Khan bashes Abhishek Malhan for being arrogant about his followers. Salman Khan did not take Abhishek Malhan's recent comments about having millions of followers too kindly. Fans, however, had a mixed reaction to the confrontation. The Bollywood superstar seemed quite upset about the YouTuber talking about his followers and how he deserves to win the show. Salman sarcastically thanked Abhishek for making the show popular and helping the team to run their houses. However, Abhishek Malhan's fans did not take Salman Khan's words kindly as they rallied for his support. A section of audience, however, also supported Salman Khan for showing Abhishek the mirror and calling out his arrogance. That's all for today's news bulletin. I am Rich Srivastav signing off. Thank you.